One of the things that I mentioned in that prayer of Elijah was that the devil has a fake imitation of God's blessings. And he's got a false prayer, and it's called worry. Worry has never solved anything. It will consume you. It will destroy you. And I got down to my PowerPoint there, and I said, if you're going to worry, don't pray. And if you're going to pray, don't worry. Not only did I say that Sunday, we finished up on prayer, specifically when Peter was in prison, the church was praying he'd be released, and God released him, and the church wouldn't believe it, wouldn't even let him in. We continued on prayer, and I said that again. If you're going to worry, don't pray. If you're going to pray, don't worry. Then an interesting thing happened. I had an appointment with a cardiologist Thursday. Knew I had problems, but I didn't expect to hear what I heard. You know, I knew that I had a little problem with heart valve. I didn't think much about it. My GP had found it and made an appointment with a cardiologist for me. And he told me when I went, he said, well, you've got a heartburn. He put me on that little table there that they call the examining table. It's sure not a bed. But he didn't listen to me. He didn't examine me. Everything else. So I'm on that table. He's sitting over in one chair. Janet's sitting over in another chair. And I thought I'd be smart and try to pretend I was intelligent. And I said, well, doctor, what's the procedure for this? You know, I figured they had pills and shots for everything now. And he told me what I didn't want to hear and what I didn't expect to hear. He said, open heart surgery. I didn't want to hear that. But you know, the instant he said it, God spoke to me. This morning we looked at Elijah in that still small voice. Well, God spoke to me, but it wasn't in the voice of many waters. And it wasn't in a still small voice. As clearly as I'm here, I heard God speak. Janet didn't hear it. The doctor didn't hear it. But in my mind, I heard God speak. And let me tell you, he didn't say what I thought he'd say. He didn't sound like what I thought he'd sound like. He sounded like an older gentleman with a jovial joke in his voice. And he spoke in a country southern accent. All you snowbirds, I want to tell you, God spoke to me this week and he spoke like a southern country gentleman. Live with it. Well, you know, God comes to us where we are. And he speaks to us in familiar terms. And I'm just a little country boy. And I grew up and God spoke to me like somebody that's been in my background. And another thing, he spoke to me in a teasing, joking tone. Now, Chris and I carry on our banner back and forth. I didn't expect God to carry on that banner. But he came like a friend. And he said words that are shocking, not what you expect to hear from God. And as soon as the doctor said open heart surgery, God said, what you going to do about that, big boy? Just about like that. And immediately, I remember last Sunday's sermons, where I said, if you're going to worry, don't pray. And if you're going to pray, don't worry. And God called me up and said, well, did you mean that or were you just preaching? Were you giving principles to live by or were you giving platitudes? I thought last Sunday I was preaching to you folks. Found out God was speaking through me to me. It's often said, be careful what you pray for. I guess you better be careful what you preach. Because the words come back. Well, I sat there on that table and I said, God, you've got such a sense of humor. And I was trying to suppress a smile because I was there and just been told I was facing open heart surgery. And I didn't want that doctor to think I'd gone totally bonkers by smiling or laughing on hearing those words. I didn't really care what Janet heard. She already knows I'm bonkers. Well, you know, here's the bottom line. If God could speak to me, and he did, and if he could speak to me like a friend, carry on a joking, banter-type conversation, and if God could say to me, what you going to do about that, big boy? And then call to mind my words. If you're going to worry, don't pray. If you're going to pray, don't worry. If God talks to me like that, what have I got to worry about? So, I've had so many people, and I appreciate it so much, saying you're going to be praying for me. Pray. but pray for God's will. Because we don't know what is best, but God does. Whatever happens, we're going to glorify God. And He's going to get the glory. In my absence, however long it may be, we're asking Chris to be acting pastor. I gave him my Bible in the service this morning. Just like Elijah threw his cloak onto Elisha. I don't have a cloak, I got a shirt. I could take it off my back and give it to him, but it'd be big enough for him and James both, probably for some more. So instead of passing my cloak, I passed him my Bible and said, safeguard it till I come again. And let it be a reminder that you are to get godly men who will preach the Bible clearly, concisely, and with power and without compromise. For unless we're preaching God's word, we're not preaching. Unless we're living God's word, we're not living. Well, that's all I've got to say. Just to share with you that whatever happens, it's in God's hands. Now, the hospital called yesterday or Friday to schedule the surgery. Guess what? We weren't at the condo and they didn't call me on my cell phone and we didn't get the word. So it still hadn't been scheduled yet. And let me say this. They're not going to do anything until they do a heart catheterization. And depending on what they see, it is within the realm of possibility that they'll do the heart cath and decide they don't want to go any further. That's possible. But if they should need, they will immediately after the heart cath go on and do the surgery. And they've asked me for my permission, and I've given it to them to do whatever is necessary to do. I just want to tell you, this church needs you like it's never needed you before. It's time to come out of the cave, as we preach this morning, and put your shoulder to the wheel. You need to pray for Chris. He now is the acting pastor of Vermont Beach Baptist Church. You need to pray for Robert. And you need to pray that God is going to give you the gumption, the will, and the dedication to be what God has called you to be and to do what God's called you to do. And in this church, we need you. And in your church back home, God needs you. It's time for us to get serious about serving God. Thank you.